My brothers and my sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has gifted us all with the gift that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows us to use every single day. This gift is none other than the ability to articulate speech. And my brothers and my sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He speaks about this gift. And He speaks about it in the Quran and He says,
الرحمن علم القرآن خلق الإنسان علمه البيان.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He starts off by saying His beautiful name, Ar-Rahman, the most merciful. علم القرآن, it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has taught us the Quran. خلق الإنسان, it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has created mankind. And then He says, علمه البيان, it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has taught us how to articulate speech, how to speak. So my brothers and my sisters in Islam, this ability to speak is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has gifted us. And we want to use this gift in a way that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, He says to Abu Dhar radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, and by extension to every single one of us, and He says, Ya Abu Dhar, عليك بالصمت فإنه مطردة للشيطان وعون لك على أمر دينك. He says, O Abu Dhar, for you and by extension for every single one of us inshallah, that we are to adhere to being quiet. Why? This helps us to expel the shaitan and this will help us to stay firm and to stay steadfast on our religion. On an occasion, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu was sitting with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and one of the other companions, he spoke ill of Abu Bakr, and Abu Bakr remained quiet. And then he spoke ill of him again, the second time and the third time, and then Abu Bakr remained quiet. But the third time, Abu Bakr got up and he defended himself. But then the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he stood up and he left. So Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu found this quite grave. Why did the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam leave? So he went after the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he says, have I done anything wrong? He says, have I done anything to upset you, O Prophet of Allah? So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, no. But when he was speaking ill about you, an angel had come down and he descended and he was saying that this person is saying lies. And then once you got up to speak and defend yourself, then the angel left and the shaitan came. And I am not to be of a person who sits in the presence of the shaitan. So my brothers and my sisters in Islam, we need to take heed and we need to be aware that we use this tongue inshallah not to speak ill about others, and not even to, when we are engaging in dialogue, that we're not going to engage in this dialogue where we're going to start debating and becomes heated and then shaitan would come and get in between us. Indeed, my brothers and my sisters in Islam, if the tongue has not been tamed, then the shaitan will use this tongue for his advantage and he will use this tongue so he can affect your iman. My brothers and my sisters in Islam, the way you use your tongue has a direct correlation with your faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, لا يستقيم إيمان عبد حتى يستقيم قلبه ولا يستقيم قلبه حتى يستقيم لسانه. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi وسلم, he says that the person's faith will not be steadfast until his heart becomes steadfast, and his heart will not be steadfast until his tongue becomes steadfast. So you can see here there's a correlation between the tongue and the heart and faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, be of those who tame the tongue, and we only use this tongue so we can speak good, not speak ill of people, not swear, not engage in talk that we shouldn't be engaging in. My brothers and my sisters in Islam, this is something that's very important and it has an effect on your iman. The first step for someone to be steadfast on the tongue is to leave everything that they shouldn't be involved in. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, مِنْ حُسْنِ إِمَانِ الْمَرْءِ تَرْكُهُ مَا لَا يَعْنِيهِ. The example, or the one who has good faith, is the one who would leave everything that they shouldn't be involved in. Whatever the circumstance, if they have no involvement in, they shouldn't be going after it and speaking about it. Just leave it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says in a hadith, مَنْ كَانَ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ فَلْيَقُلْ خَيْرًا أَوْ لِيَصْمُتْ. That whomever believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then let him only say what is good, or then let him remain silent, or let him remain quiet. My brothers and my sisters in Islam, try to take this as an opportunity in your life inshallah, that any time that you will speak, any time that you want to utter some words that come out of your mouth, think, will these words bring goodness or will they bring the opposite? If it brings the opposite, then take the advice of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and say that I'm not going to utter these words. Remain quiet. This is the advice of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. How many times do we see people, instead of using their tongue to get people closer, rather they use their tongue so they can split people away, whether it's between a husband and a wife, or between two brothers who are quarreling, or it's between a father and a son, whatever the circumstance is. Don't be of those who use the tongue so you can split people away. Rather, use your tongue so you can bring goodness into this world. My brothers and my sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Quran,
قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِلزَّكَاةِ فَاعِلُونَ
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, indeed, the believers are the ones who are successful. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then applies those conditions to those who are successful from the believers. They are the ones who have khushu', they have God consciousness in their prayer. So whilst they're praying, they're thinking of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And of course, this is the second pillar of our Islam. You know, the five pillars of Islam, we've got the shahada, then we have the salat. Then what comes after salat? It is zakat. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He also says, one of the conditions in these verses, He says, they are the ones who also pay their zakat. But my brothers and my sisters in Islam, between these two pillars of Islam, between the prayer and between the zakat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inserts something, and He says, they are the ones whom refrain from any talk that is useless. Any talk that is useless, they stay clear, they stay far away from this. Why? My brothers and my sisters in Islam, this is to show you again the importance of using this tongue only for what is good, not for gossiping, not for talking about things that are completely useless or have no factual basis or no evidence at all. Let us use our tongue, inshallah, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as He has gifted us with this, and we have a grave responsibility with this great gift. My brothers and my sisters in Islam, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ Verily, I was sent to complete and perfect the noble manners. And to have the best and the noble manners is for one of us to use the tongue in the best manner. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to use this tongue for His sake and for His pleasure. جزاكم الله خيرا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.